what's your name?
Jack Rhodes.
And is what you're going to do today how you make a living, or do you have a normal job?
I did have a normal job.
Which was?
Which was a nuclear engineer.
Flipping heck!
Which makes me sound cleverer than I am, to be fair.
And how did your parents feel when you gave up being a nuclear scientist for being a magician?
They weren't impressed, yeah. My dad used to call me a part-time wizard. Sorry, full-time moron. He's not my biggest fan.
Do you think you could win?
I think at the end of this, you'll either be going, wow, how did he do that? Or you'll be going, wow, why did he do that?
At least he's honest, though.
So you could see yourself in Vegas?
Yeah, that'd be the dream. I think the go-to guys would be Penn and Teller doing a show like that. Yeah.
Not going to ask any more questions. Good luck.
I'm pretty surprised you don't recognise me. I might have been on before.
Go on.
When?
You didn't see me. Do you remember the invisible magician, the Phantom?
Yes.
Yes!
That might have been me.
No!
You can't see me.
Oh!
You'll never see me.
Oh, my God.
I'm standing right in front of one of the judges.
You didn't see me at the time, because I'm like a gangly ninja. I can move undetected. I'll show you what I mean, using these blank cards. Now, Simon, I'm going to have you write down a word for me. What's the first word that comes to mind when you look at me?
Remember, it's a family show.
Yeah. What have we got? Cucumber.
I don't know why.
It's the tall, skinny cucumber and... Simon, hold out your left hand for me. Put your right hand on top, we're gonna sandwich it. Perfect, cucumber in between. Make sure I don't get to it, okay? Now, I get to get my own back now.
Oh no.
When I look at you, the first word that comes to mind is... minted.
Minted.
Bruno, hold out your left hand for me. Perfect, minted. Yeah. You're gonna put your right hand on top, sandwich it, make sure no one can get to it. Perfect. Two different words, cucumber, minted. I'm now going to move undetected. That's it. Job done. Simon, show everyone what's now written on your card.
No.
Minted. And if you've got my word, Simon, Bruno, show them. Cucumber.
I can't believe this is not real.
What was that?
Now, here's the thing, OK? I'm going to show you exactly what just happened. Now, Simon, cucumber. Put your right hand on top, sandwich it. Make sure no one can get to it. Bruno, exact same thing. Minted. Right hand on top, sandwich it. Now, here's what you didn't see the first time, OK? I'm going to do action replay, but this time in slow motion to show you how I move undetected, all right? It's like an out-of-body experience. Here we go.
What the hell is going on?
Job done. Undetected. All right, I'm lying. Really, I'm lying. Show him.
What?
No, come on.
No.
I've been lying the whole time. At the start of this, I showed you a video claiming the Phantom was me allegedly. But I posted another video, a prediction, called What Simon Will Think Of. Uploaded 6 months ago, you were only ever going to think of one word. Cucumber.
That's unbelievable.
Wow. No way.
How? Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Jack Rhodes. Thank you very much.
What's that about then?
Cheers, mate. Thank you. Thank you. Cheers. Bruno, it's been so good being here. Thank you. Cheers. Thanks for having me. Cheers. Alicia, it's been amazing. Thank you. Cheers. Simon, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thanks for having me, man. It's been amazing. Cheers, guys. Thank you.
I am so confused. Is that the end of the act?
Is that the end?
I think so. Is that it? Are you done?
Yeah, we're doing the judging bit now, or...?
We're just slightly distracted by the box and the scuba diver.
Scuba diver?
The phantom.
I loved the way you presented that. I've never seen it done like that before. That felt really fresh. You're very cool with a sick sense of humour as well, which
like
I love.
Like a cucumber.
See?
I cannot get out of my mind because I held this card. How you do it. I'm gobsmacked, that's all I can say.
You've got great showmanship, it was funny, you've kept us on our toes, and I can't wait to see what you might get up to next.
I think you're really smart, and I think to be a great magician, you've got to be really smart. You have massive potential, I genuinely mean that.
Something really good about you.
Cheers, thank you.
The only thing lacking for me was the ending didn't feel big enough. It because the end was big.
Let's take a vote. Bruno.
Yes.
Alicia.
I'm saying yes.
Don't think we've ever seen anything like that. 100% yes. Simon.
That's as good as you're going to get. You got 4 yeses. You made me feel like
a stars and we're dancing out in space. Dad's got it wrong, I think.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. Cheers.
don't me.
You're very, very good. And your quick change was beautiful. I mean, it was really amazing.
Thank you so much.
You did it very uniquely. The mixture of magic and your performance made it so much more special. You're the best quick change artist we have ever seen.
Yes,
you really are.
I agree.
Thank you.
You look beautiful, professional. It was entertaining. We loved you tonight. I want to see more.
Gracias.
Sometimes when we have these acts, you have a lady who does the quick change and then normally an annoying guy who does nothing. And the fact that you were on your own and did it, for me, made it just so much better. It was so slick, and you've got 2 minutes to cram that in. That was amazing.
Thank you so much. All right, let's vote. Yes or no, Simon?
Well, obviously, yes.
Yes.
Third yes.
Thank you. And I'm going to give you a fourth yes.
Come and can see, my fingers are here. Real finger, okay? Let's make sure it's real finger.
It's real fingers, yeah.
Yeah. Don't blink.
No! He just took out his finger!
I'm gonna put it somewhere else. I'm gonna put it back, like.
What?
No!
I didn't say I'm gonna do a magic trick. A card, I'm gonna put it on my pinky. Yeah? Now watch carefully. So the card goes here and slowly I'm gonna crush it. Like... Yeah, now we all have like 4 fingers, right? Now watch, I'm gonna put it back, watch here. 1, 2, 3. Oh, sorry, that's too much, that's too much. I'll put it back like for real, yeah. Thank you. Okay, this one is for Sofia.
For me?
Okay, please check the ring. It's just a ring, right? Yeah?
Beautiful.
Thank you. Now watch carefully. It's on my pinky and watch. It jumps, right? One more time, so it's on my ring finger and it jumps like this. Thank you. And then, Simon, I want you to watch carefully because many people think I moved the ring very quickly, but actually, I didn't move the ring. Watch, I moved the finger.
No!
I sidled finger, yeah. Thank you so much.
Amazing. I can't believe what I just saw.
Crazy, son, that was crazy. I had never seen anything like this.
Never. I don't know how you did that.
Yeah.
That's actually one of the most crazy close-up magic I've ever seen. I loved it.
Thank you, Simon.
Yes.
Crazy fingers, Sam. We've never seen anything close to that. This was the most unique. I'm right here in front of me. You're amazing.
Thank you so much.
You are amazing. I love that you came all the way from Taiwan to show us that. I couldn't believe my eyes. I loved it too.
Thank you so much.
Okay, perfect. We're gonna vote. Sam, I'm gonna give you your first yes.
Thank you.
Simon!
Yes!
Thank you.
Oh.
Heidi!
Yes!
Thank you.
And I am giving you your fourth yes.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. Bye, everyone. Thank you.
That was pretty amazing.
What's going on? What's happened?
This is terrifying.
We've been here before.
Oh my God, that felt scary. One of them took me into the basement.
They've been on the show before.
Have they?
Yeah, all three of them individually.
We have come from a time where there is no magic.
A time when childlike wonder and the feeling of magic has been destroyed through technology.
And without magic, the world's crumbling. It's turned to nothing. It's just turned to fog. And as hard as it might be to believe that we've somehow traveled in time, we can provide you with some kind of proof. If I were to ask you to choose, for example, one of these cards, I can tell you that I know that you will choose the Four of Clubs. And I know that you'll choose the Two of Hearts. And I know that because we've been here before and we've already seen this happen. So would you touch any card you'd like? Just touch one, yes. Take it out, good. And Alicia, would you touch one as well? Just take one out. And I know, even though all the cards are totally different, I've seen it happen already. I know that you have, Bruno, the Four of Clubs. Have a look.
What?
And I know that you have the Two of Hearts.
Wow. I am impressed.
Amanda.
Yes?
Can you dry out the teacup for me and place it back down? Perfect. You just do the saucer as well for me. Perfect. We're going to place the saucer on top of the cup. Hold your hands out now. I want you to take hold of this. Hold it up really high. Now, for us to travel through time, to travel through a portal, we actually turn to dust. But when we manipulate time, we damage the very fabric of reality. Everything is slipping through our fingers, and the world is turning to fog. Things aren't where they're supposed to be. Look inside the cup.
Oh my gosh. That sand is in the cup.
Oh my God!
Well, sometime in the future, we found a journal.
As we started to study the journal, we noticed that every page contains a different theory about time travel.
Bruno, hold your finger out like this. I'm going to riffle down the pages, and I want you just to put your finger in one of these pages. Right now, this one. Page 73. This is how to travel into someone's memory.
This page describes to us how that feeling that you sometimes get in the back of your head, that you might have seen something before, it's more than just a feeling. It's actually there to provide you with proof that you really are reliving something.
While he does that, Alicia, Amanda, I would love you both to examine these dice. Just roll them gently a few times on the desk. Just make sure they're regular, real dice that they roll on different numbers. Would you kindly roll that into the bowl? And let's see, you have rolled the number 4. Amanda, would you do the same thing, please? Would you please roll into the bowl as well? 6. Perfect. 4 and 6. Oh my, look.
As we start to play with and collapse time and space, sometimes hard to tell if we are on the outside of the hourglass and looking in, or if maybe we might really be on the inside and we're looking out.
From the past to the present and the present to the future, magic can only be protected by those who possess the ability for childlike wonder.
And those who can take that feeling and carry it into the future.
To see you, Ben. Bang on time. Colin, Elizabeth. Feels like 2024. Simon, can I just say, you are looking amazing. You are Bruno. Good to see you, Bruno. My name's Aiden. Sometimes the things that feel like they're happening spontaneously in the present have actually been written into our lives far in the past. The numbers you all chose earlier couldn't have been more random, yeah? But long, long before tonight's show, Ben had seen them.
And he knew these numbers would be the only thing that proves time travel is real. So he wrote them down in a place where they could never get lost and never be altered.
Random numbers chosen in this very moment. 4 and a 2 from a deck of cards. A random book opened to page 73. And of course, 2 dice roll to the numbers 4 and 6. Numbers hidden by the passage of time, and now proof that that feeling at the back of Ben's head is more than just a feeling.
Don't worry, you got this, Aiden.
What?
There's one more thing that we need to share with you.
Nothing is as it seems.
Simon, it's time. Oh, what?
Shivers, hello.
Why does it always end up being Simon?
Would you stand up and come with me? You're completely safe, I promise, okay?
Oh, no.
Thank you, sir. I'm gonna put a blindfold on you, but you are safe, okay?
Nothing is as it seems. Oh my god.
Nothing is as it seems.
What is Simon?
God in the in-between.
Where is Simon?
I'm scared.
That's about to be insane. Oh, guys, honestly, I am so nervous.
Have fun out there. Good luck. Thank you.
Hello, hello. What's your name?
Trixy.
Your mum named you Trixy?
Well, my name's Ricardo, but magician Trixy for today.
So you're going to do magic?
Yes.
Do you make a living from this?
Do you know what? I've got 2 jobs. I do magician and my electrician.
Who did you come here with, Trixy?
Yeah, I've got my missus and my 2 kids over there, in the corner there.
I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting.
I live with my partner and my 2 kids. I've got a 13-year-old boy and a 9-year-old girl.
Today we've met, he's always shown me tricks.
I tricked your mum to get with me.
You've definitely done that. Like this might be my
time to shine. Our dad's always doing magic. He does it at school, at parties, everywhere.
He goes to work 5 days a week. He does night shift and day shift. And he's always helping out the kids with their homework. That same night, he might have a magic gig.
My favourite thing about my dad, that he's so ambitious and hardworking, and he never gives up.
It's definitely a dad that's always inspiring them. Follow your dreams. If the kids say, oh, I want to do ballet, next week, they're in ballet.
Do you think your dad deserves to get a yes today?
Yeah, more than a yes, an excellent, amazing, because he is amazing and excellent.
Like a colossal yes.
He does everything to help everybody else. So it's his time now to follow his dreams.
Well done, Trixy. Good luck then.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Hype me up. How everyone doing? All right, cool. Let's go. Today, I'm going to be creating a magical moment in time. I cannot do that alone. I'm going to need the help of the four lovely judges. Bruno.
Yeah?
Can I borrow your watch, please?
Okay, here we go.
Show everyone, hold it up, bye. Can you all see the watch?
Oh, that's a nice piece, isn't it?
He's doing well for himself, isn't he?
Yeah? What I'm going to do, I'm going to put your watch in my handkerchief. Can you feel it? Just make sure it's still there.
Yeah, it's still there.
Rule number one, never trust a magician. Poof.
Wow. Yes, yes.
In this bag, I've got 50 photos of Simon Cowell's memories. To show you they're all different, I need you to select a random photo. Bruno,
right,
can you close your eyes and take a random photo? Yep, take one, just one. Reveal it and show Simon.
I remember that. That is the premiere of the One Direction movie. I've got a great tan.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. It's you and King Charles.
Looks like I'm being told off.
Now, Simon, we're going to do this slightly different.
Okay.
With your right hand,
yeah.
I need you to pick a random photo. Close your eyes.
I really am, Chad.
And pick a random one, anyone you want.
Anyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, do not open it. Same thing with your left hand. You can open your eyes.
Yeah.
Hang on to that and follow me.
Scared. What's gonna happen?
What about my watch?
Now, Simon, about a month ago,
yeah,
I had a dream about two memories. In fact, it wasn't my memories. These was, in fact, your memories.
Really?
The first dream that I had was a memory about unconditional love. There was a lot of barking by dogs and it woke me up. Do me a favor, Simon. The first photo with your right hand, can you please reveal that photo, please? Show the camera, please.
It's Pebbles.
It's the new one.
After my dream, I had this made. It's a custom dog tag with the name Pebbles.
No, you didn't.
Have a look.
Are you serious?
What?
That's unbelievable.
So now, the second dream I had, you made a purchase for £10,500 on the 21st of March, 1994. I want to show you something, Simon. Do you recognize this?
Yeah. That's a TR6.
Oh, my gosh.
Have a look at your photo.
What?
That's my car.
I remember that car.
That was one of my favorite ever cars.
Now, Simon, I am about to reunite you with someone special. Simon Cowell, let me reunite you with the blast from a past. Simon, this is your exact car from
really?
30 years ago, exactly the same one. It's not a duplicate. Come round here, Simon, come round. Simon, do me a favor.
Yeah?
Go inside the glove box. There's a gift inside there, Simon. Do not open it.
Okay.
But take it out.
All right.
Let's go back on stage. Give it up for Simon one more time.
This is like unreal.
Smashed it.
In the box.
Simon.
Yeah.
Give that box to Bruno, but do not open it.
Bruno.
One more time for Simon Cowell and the judges. Bruno, open that box.
Oh my God. How did you do?
Hey, Bruno, watch, guys.
That's unbelievable.
Thank you, guys. Glad you enjoyed. Magician Trixy, guys.
I was very engaged in the storytelling. You know, I was totally taken by your magic.
Thank you.
What I think I loved most about it all was that it was proper magic, but it was big magic.
That time of my life, I was literally broke. I borrowed some money and I bought that car. And it was like a turning point in my life. Just seeing how much, obviously, this means to you, I had no idea what was going to happen next.
Were you really nervous at the beginning? Because I felt it.
Slightly.
You've got to start believing in yourself more because you're so talented. If this is an indication of what you can do going forward, I really believe great things are going to happen.
OK, we're going to take a vote. Bruno.
Oh, definitely yes.
Thank you.
Nicely done. It's a yes from me.
Thank it's you. A yes from me.
Thank you.
4 million yeses.
I discovered magic 7 years ago. I saw magicians on America's Got Talent. That really inspired me to get into magic myself.
Yes, Oscar, yes!
Cillian was diagnosed with autism. He just didn't engage with the other children and we just knew ourselves that something wasn't right. It is hard. But when he discovered the magic, it was like a light switch.
That is amazing.
Oh my God.
You are unbelievably talented.
Now, Simon, I want you to think of a magic word.
A dog.
Just to see him smiling and doing what he loves.
Dog.
It's just priceless.
The third place act, Cillian O'Connor.
I was very proud of myself for making it to third place.
13-year-old Cillian O'Connor joins us now.
I've had interviews on TV, radio, newspapers.
You are genuinely, I think, one of the best magicians we've ever, ever had on our shows.
When Simon chose me to be on his dream team, I just couldn't believe it.
What I love about magic is that when I understand what the main story is,
yes.
I think it makes it more special.
It really does.
Yeah. So my one piece of advice is tell a story and use great music.
There's a lot of magic here tonight.
It is.
Yeah.
Yes.
Us, Anna de Guzman.
Yeah. Like a lot of good magic, yes. Right?
Okay, here we go, guys, clearing stage.
There is a lot of great competition here, but I really do think I have a chance of winning. I'm gonna put up a good fight. With words, we can paint the world with kindness and create magic in everyday moments. Simon, the last time we met, I asked you to think of a magic word, which you wrote down on this hanky. Your magic word, dog. I'll leave it here. Now, I know you hate card tricks, but yeah. Don't worry. It's not one of those. I've written some random words on the back of these cards. Take this half and mix them up whilst I mix these. Howie, please, say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
Read whatever is written on the back, but don't let me see.
Okay.
Simon, in a world that's often upside down, there's a chance for fun and happy moments to pop up when we least expect them. Let's bring our two halves together as one, so we can find joy in this chaos. What if we could create a special moment of magic by making these mixed up words rearrange themselves to tell my story? Impossible, right? It's done. Forget what we're told. Simon, I'm here because of you.
Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Howie, I asked you to choose a card which was the...
Nine of Spades.
The Nine of Spades. Let's try this. You know, Howie, only those who believe in magic can truly find it. Watch very, very, very closely. What was the word written on the back of the card that you chose?
Believe.
What? Now, Simon, show everyone what's written on the hanky.
Believe.
Changed.
My teacher, Mrs. Kirwin, always says, if you truly believe, then anything is possible. I used to be on the outside looking in, but now I'm on the inside looking out.
Standing.
Thank you.
Thank you. My gosh.
Howie.
You know, this show, AGT and all the GTs around the world, are all about diversity. Anybody from any walk of life should be able to compete and have their dreams come true, including neurodiversity. And yeah, you are truly amazing, not only as a magician, but as a human being.
Thank you very much.
Heidi.
It was really, really great. It is a real show. And not just like a little act, like we could watch a whole show with you. Well done, young man.
Look, I've seen a lot of magic on these shows over the years, and I think you really, really have something special about you. You're 14 years old, and you've come all the way, thousands of miles, to come up with something so incredible. Just blew my mind. I really love you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Making paper airplanes reminds me of fond memories. Well, as we grow older, our memories fade with time.
It's gone.
Memories are invisible, but are the most precious things in my life.
I was excited.
Say it.
Obviously, being Yu's mentor, it's special.
You're not his mentor.
You're not.
We have a connection. You've developed this very cool, laid-back Vegas-style persona, world class.
I agree. Now, you're not just cool. You're kind of very slick and very confident. I love how you are with it all. It's like, yeah, I can do this. Yeah, I can do that. Good.
Thank you so much.
Howie!
That was the best magic act I have seen in the last 5 years.
That's saying a lot.
And the ability to rise to that level working not even with your mentor of choice.
I know.
Good point.
Listen, I see the Heidi in there. I've said this a couple times tonight, only 5 acts can go through. I promise you, you are going to be one of the 5.
Good luck to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Woohoo! Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Mark Clearview.
What are you going to do for us today?
I'm going to do magic like you've never seen it before.
Oh. Ooh. You know, we do get quite a few magicians on this stage.
Yes.
What makes you stand out?
I'm the only one here.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. How did you get into magic?
I got into magic when I was 3 years old and the witch put the curse on me. And then my father decided to continue to help me. He built props for me. He drove me to my shows. And I wouldn't be here today without him. So on a serious note, thank you, Dad, for helping out.
Nice.
Yes.
Yeah. Is your dad no longer with us?
Yeah, I lost my father to cancer last year, so I'm still kind of getting used to that being real. But if he was here today, it was one of his dreams to see me on a show like this.
He is here.
Thank you. Yeah.
Let's do it, baby. The stage is yours.
Nothing in my hands. Nothing in my sleeves. And yet,
magic. And as the eggs continue to appear at my fingertips, another egg, another egg, another egg, another egg, another egg. Now that you have a bowl that's filled to the brim with eggs.
Oh.
I will not be doing any egg tricks.
Or will I?
Hit it.
Go.
You're so weird.
My name is Mark Clearview, obviously. I've been doing magic since I was 6 years old. But most six-year-olds would rather be firefighters and protect the public. And I was like, I'll be a magician and protect my virginity. The jokes are out of the way. It's time for the miracles. Howie, think of a word.
Okay.
Any word. And you know what? Not something too long. A five-letter word. I'm not that good, clearly.
Okay.
Yeah, send it to me. Five-letter word. Send it to me. Don't say it out loud. Howie, out of curiosity, is the first letter of your word an H?
Yes.
Wow.
Don't clap. It wastes time. K.
No.
Is not in your word. I wasn't finished my sentence. K is not in your word, correct?
Correct.
Wow, brilliant. How does he do it?
L?
Nope.
There's no L. I'm losing. Let's try a card trick. Those are easier. An ordinary deck of cards. You know what? Think of a card, Lily. Think of a card.
Any card.
Okay. Any card. It's time for the magic.
Mm.
One card in my hand. I'm locked in, Lily.
Okay.
What card are you thinking of?
Five of hearts.
The five of hearts?
Yes.
I lost again, okay? Lost again. Look, we got a long way to go.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Hit it. Here we go.
This is a roller coaster.
I know.
Wow. The end.
Feel good.
Come on. Yeah, yeah. You all right? You all right? Still okay here? Yeah.
I fell. What was the card that you said?
Five of hearts.
There's a chicken there?
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Can you open it?
Open the chicken?
Open that chicken. And in,
there's a card in the chicken.
Could you get the card?
Can you, Howie, spread your legs.
Stick your finger in there. Put your,
Get it.
Can you unfold that and see if that's the five of hearts?
Oh my goodness. What in the actual?
Wait.
What?
Okay, yes. I'm great, but wait. You thought of a five-letter word.
I did.
What is your word? Would you tell all of us?
I thought of Howie. I don't know why that came to me, but it did.
That's amazing because, I mean, it's kind of amazing because I have an owie here, so. Actually, could.
Amazing.
I think it's bruising, actually.
Whoa. You're on that man.
I know.
That's Howie's word. I've been Mark Clearview my whole life, and you know what? Cheers. to Dad. Thank you very much.
It's amazing.
That was like the best 2 hours of my life. You're equal parts good at magic as you are being funny. I can't believe you got me to put my hand in a chicken. Like, that Thank was you. Incredible.
Thank you.
You have a natural gift. Everything that you have delivered to us today shows a star. And that's what it's all about in this million-dollar season right here on Canada's Got
Thank
Talent.
Thank you. Thank you.
You have so much to offer.
I agree.
And and you're witty and funny. I think you're a star. I really believe tonight your father is just glowing with pride.
Should we start the voting, Howie?
Oh, there's no question about this yes. It's 1,000 yeses from me.
I cannot wait to see how much weirder you get.
Thank you.
It's a yes for me.
And last but not least, it's a yes!
Four yeses!
Thank you.
Hello.
Oh.
Hello.
Oh, there's a lot of people here. My God, I think I'll go home.
Welcome to Canada's Got Talent.
I have no idea. What brought me here?
What question are you answering?
I'm sorry?
He's on call.
You're answering questions no one has asked you, sir. What is your name?
Mark Lewis is my name.
What are you going to do for us tonight?
I'm going to do some card tricks.
How old are you?
I'm 79 years old.
Wow. Are you having a good day?
Pardon?
Are you having a good day?
Not really, no, but...
Do you think that what you have for us today is worthy of $1 million?
What am I going to do with $1 million at my age? I'll be dead. How bloody good is that? God almighty.
If you win this...
If I win $1 million...
And if you get a golden buzzer... $25,000 from CIBC.
I don't mind that. I'll take the 25 grand right now.
But you want to win the contest, right?
No, Peter, I don't get... there's more chance of being struck by lightning than that happening. I don't have it.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Can I help you on that?
You have people doing things on trapezes and going on fire and everything, and they're worried about me coming down a few bloody stairs.
That's an act. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Yay!
Amazing! All right. Don't get too excited. You haven't seen the card trick yet. Gentlemen there, have you ever met me before?
No.
You seem happy about that. When I snap my fingers, I'd like you to think of any card in the pack now. Do you have a card in your mind?
Yes.
Don't tell me.
Okay.
Got one in your mind?
Yes.
I have a card here in my hand. Out loud, what card are you thinking of?
Ace of spades.
Ace of spades. That shut you all up for a minute, didn't it? All right, let's try this now. Would you help me, my dear?
Yes.
Would you take any card you like, but remember you have a free choice? Take any one you like.
I love this guy.
Show it to them. Don't let me see it. You can show it to the audience.
Show it to the audience?
I'll take my glasses off so I can't see it by accident, okay? All right, put the card back in the pack anywhere you want. Now, the idea of the trick is, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to make your card come to the top of the pack, okay?
Okay.
May I know your name?
Lily.
Lily. This card here should be your card. It might not be, I don't know, but we'll see. We all make mistakes. My mother made one. Well, let's try it. Come on. Was that your card?
No.
It wasn't?
Oh, no.
Bloody hell. All right. Take the 8 with your thumb on top. Thumb on top. Yep, that's your thumb. Push it in the middle anywhere you like. Hold on to the 8 very tightly.
Yeah.
The card above the 8 should be your card. Was it this one?
No.
What was the name of your card?
Six of Diamonds.
Six of Diamonds.
Yeah.
Turn that one over.
No! What?
Wow.
What?
Wow.
I'm going to run the cars from one hand to the other like that. I'd like all four of you to call out stop anytime you like. We'll use the card to stop me. Are you ready?
Yep.
Say stop quickly.
Stop.
Too slow, you've got to be quick. Say stop quickly.
Stop.
Too slow, you've got to be quick. Say stop quickly.
Stop.
I haven't started yet. Look, I will slow down. You speed up. We'll meet in the middle, all right? That's the best way to do it. All right. Say stop anytime you like.
Stop.
Have a look at that card. Show it to them. Don't let me see it. Okay, everybody know the card. Put the card back somewhere. There, that's very good. Will you give me five guesses, five chances to find your card? Say yes.
Yes.
Good. Because if you say no, it's not much of a trick. This might be your card. It might be this one.
Okay.
It might be, oh, I don't bloody know. Oh, that one there. Two more guesses. Look, it might be that one. It might be this one.
Okay.
No, I don't know. I think, I hope, I pray that one of these five cards is the chosen card. Tell me, was that the card?
No.
All right, it doesn't matter. I've still got four cards left. So it's probably one of these four. Was this the card? No.
Mm-mm.
Third time's a charm, although I'm not that charming. Is your card, was it there?
It is not.
No. Mm-hmm. Is it either of those two cards?
No.
No.
Well, just touch one of the five cards now. Touch one quick. Keep your finger on it. I could not possibly have known beforehand which of the five you'd touch. Is that correct?
Correct.
Tell me the name of your card.
Ace of Spades.
Oh, it's all the same one you thought of, the Ace of Spades again. Coincidence. Well. All right. We'll turn that one over slowly. What have you got? Show it to the... There we are, lady, the Ace of Spades. Thank you very much, everybody.
Wow.
Good health. Good luck.
Yes,
bye-bye. Thank you very much.
Watch you.
Wait. Watch behind you. Watch behind you.
What I'll do this. Okay.
There we go.
Okay.
You good on this?
Thank you, Howie. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Cheerio.
Wow. I'll start. I just think that you are not only magical, you are such a great, lovable character. For a guy that comes out and doesn't even know where he is, you are the sharpest person I have met so far this season.
You're born to do magic and comedy. Thank you for coming.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
Trish.
Yeah, an absolute delight. I would like to take you home with me.
Oh, that's very nice.
It's fun.
The offers I get coming here.
I was literally flabbergasted. That magic was so good, and I just loved your personality, and this is the type of talent that could possibly win $1 million.
Okay.
Okay.
Am I supposed to go now?
No, we gotta go.
Here's how it goes. I'm gonna give you a yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Lily?
I'm also going to give you a yes.
That's two yeses. Trish?
I'm going to give you your third yes.
Cardi? Cardi?
And this is only for reference. I'm Cardinal giving you a yes.
Four yeses.
Okay. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
I don't know where I'm going. Oh, it's this way, is it? Oh, thank you very much.
Howie's requesting a producer to the judge's desk, please.
Thank you, Mark.
He just sent that.
Howie needs us to hold the set.
So I'm going to have to be stuck in a holding.
Something's happening here. Stand by.
I'm just thinking, we just let do like everybody, young and old, laughing.
I'm down.
Okay.
Lindsay?
Yeah.
Are you still back there with our buddy?
I am, yeah.
Can we talk to Mark for one more second?
But here we go. You can just go right on stage there. Yeah. Mark Lewis!
I want to ask you something. I've just been apprised of some stuff. You emailed our producers, didn't you?
I did, yeah.
And I'll just read a line. It said, am I going to have to be stuck in a holding room for hours with hundreds of eager contestants? I would regard this possibility with abject horror. And you wouldn't see me near the place. Like, you're not happy to be here.
I'm happy now.
Do you love this guy? Okay. Lindsay, come here. Lindsay, come here for a minute.
You want to give him $25,000?
Well, Mark, as a group, let's put our hands together. Here's $25,000. Even that.
Nearly had a heart attack there.
You can't see me, but I can see you. I'm standing in front of one of the judges.
Who?
What is that?
Sophia. I didn't do it.
Sophia,
Sophia, please go onto the stage.
Good luck, Sophia!
You're gonna get caught. Don't blame me.
Please reach inside the box and choose just one piece of paper. Don't read it yet, just hold it in your hand, and she will read your mind. Sophia, look in the smoke. And tell Simon what you see.
I see a house. A ghost is inside. The doors keep moving. The family's afraid.
Simon, please open the paper you chose. What does it say?
It says... The family's afraid because a ghost's in their house moving the doors. And it was Olive.
I have to go now. Please remember me. I will